Hi again guys, I'm back with another unboxing. This one's come very quickly actually. I've even ordered a bunch of these actually yesterday. And this is the first of four that have arrived today on a Saturday. And we were ordered on a Friday morning, which is quite impressive, really. So yeah, something I've wanted for quite some time, just never quite got around to buying in the past. Oh, that looks excellent, doesn't it? That's a little bit smaller than I thought. Not that that's a problem, just slightly surprising. So yeah, here we go, a Perplexus. This is the rookie version, which seems like a good place to start, since I've never played with one of these before. Let me just adjust the camera a little bit, because it's now that the big box is out of the way. Okay, so yeah, this is the Perplexus rookie, so 70 challenges apparently. I've seen these plenty over the years, I've just never got around to trying one for myself. And they've always interested me, they do look like fun. And it's actually Pete the Geek's fault. He opened his Star Wars one on camera yesterday and I just completely fell in love with it because I love Star Wars and like I said, I've always been interested in these. So, let's see. Roll the ball to the starting point. If you can't find it, put Perplexus rookie down and slowly step back away. Okay? Flip, twist and spin Perplexus rookie to move the ball along the numbered path. When you fall off the track, because it's going to happen, just start over. If you make it to the end, put yourself on the back. Oh, pat yourself on the back. Then try racing your friends on the clock. Complete all four Perplexus puzzles to become a master. Well, that's wrong, because I actually ordered six Perplexus puzzles yesterday. So yeah, there's more than four coming. But yeah, there seems to be a couple that... You got the obvious knockoff ones. These all came from eBay, by the way. So yeah, you got the obvious knockoffs. But then there's some that are apparently Perplexus brand, but they don't sell... They don't mention them on the Perplexus official site. So I'm not really sure what's going on there. Like the I'll show you the one when I open them actually rather than talking about them now. That doesn't really make any sense, does it? Yeah, I'm really not sure which packages have come today, so I cheated slightly. I had a look in the box to find this one first. I wanted to do them in order sort of thing. Not tidy anything up. I've got a little stand there. To go with it. See if I can get into the damn thing. Not even with a knife apparently. There we go. Nice little stand. Keep it safe. Not just rolling around. So, what kind of things we got in here? We've got like a staircase, a couple of staircase type things. I don't know if you can go on both sides of those, or because I know some, a lot of the features, looking at other videos, you actually end up using both sides of all of them. Like this thing here, I can see you have to kind of roll around the entire figure eight and you go from one side of this grey number 61. Is that 61 or is that 19? 61 piece. You come off it and go all the way around onto the other side of it. I don't know if that shows up on the camera or not, but I can see number 59. Yeah, on that grey piece, and it comes up all the way onto this kind of figure eight thing, and you go all the way around that. Doesn't actually say 60 on it, of course it's too small, I suppose. And then back onto 60 with the same grey piece, the opposite side of it, which becomes 61. So, let's see if we can find the starting position. I'm guessing, yeah, there, where it says start, will be the one. So I'm going to get that one there. Oh, it's easy enough, isn't it? Yeah. This looks like a lot of fun, really does. So where am I going? I'm going to go under all the tunnels. I don't know if you can see this. And not very well. Where's that taking me? Where's my wall? Ah, there. Okay. It's stuck. Okay. Bit of a tap. Got it through. And then the white piece there is number two. Number three. Leads me down the step. Not too fast because I don't know what's going to happen if I go too quickly. And the men here. Oh, I see. I've got to kind of get it down there. And then, oh! Maybe not. Where have I gone? Oh, no, that is right, yeah. I see. Clever. I was expecting it to come back onto that white piece again. So this is number five. This is a great fun. Obviously, I'm not just going to solve the entire thing on camera here. But yeah, this is the... I think we'll leave it there actually for now. I'm going to go away and play with it and maybe come back with some extra thoughts later. We'll see how long it takes to solve it. If it's taking me too long, I will just upload this unboxing as it is. So thank you very much for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Alright, so the Perplexus Rookie is now sold again. Let's just take it off its stand and hopefully you can see the ball rolling around in there. And I don't know if you can see with the reflections or not, but it does say End in there as well. I'm trying to show it from every angle so you can see it. Yeah, wow, this thing is fun. I have enjoyed this so much. It's taken me probably about, rough guess, 3 or 4 hours of playing. I don't know, because obviously I haven't timed myself. It's just something I've been picking up on and off all afternoon since it arrived this, around midday. And yeah, really, really thoroughly enjoyed it. It's so satisfying to play with. What I mean by that is, if you ever had some of these kind of things, much smaller versions as children, you'd find the little ball bearings would get stuck on things, and you know, through no fault of your own, you would fail because there were slight imperfections in the moulding or something like that. With this, you know, when you fail, it's entirely your fault. You know, you hope you know what you've done wrong, but it's always entirely your own fault, and that's a great thing about this. Everything works exactly as it should. I mean, there's little like drops and things that could easily go wrong, and they're just, obviously just positioned so perfectly that they work. There's a whole. I'm trying to do it without moving the ball from the end spot at the moment. If I see if I can find it, it's on the yellow staircase. If I can see that. There's the white one. Where's the yellow one? Ah, it's down the bottom. Can I get to that without dropping out the end? Yeah. So you see the yellow staircase here. And I'd have to turn it upside down to see properly, but at the end of that, I don't know if I'm getting the viewfinder very well. No, I can't really get it in the camera. You can see that little yellow hole there in the centre. Basically, the ball drops through that onto the grey track, which is actually above it at the moment, but would be below it when you actually reach that point. And yeah, it has to be very precise the way it falls through that hole and onto the track, otherwise it just fall off constantly, and it just never ever misses. It's brilliant. So yeah, I've had a huge amount of fun. This is something that I'm going to play with many more times in the future. Even though I've solved it now, it's clear to me that I will enjoy solving it again, so it's definitely going to get picked up again. It's not going to get put on a shelf to gather dust. So what I would say about this, if it's something that interests you, then go for it, get one, give it a try. I'm very much looking forward to the rest of the series now. Some have already here, I'm waiting for a couple of others to arrive as yet, and I'm so excited about trying the more challenging ones. I mean, this was challenging enough in itself, but again, the great thing is, even it's so well designed that the difficulty progression is brilliant. It starts off very easy, as you probably saw in the first part of this video, it really wasn't difficult to get around the first few steps, but it quickly became challenging just to see what you had to do next. There's one part in it in particular where it drops down a little hole. It's perfectly secure at the time, but try and figure out what you've got to do to get it out of that bit that it's in. You can't see it very well, and you're trying to figure out. I must have dropped it out of there 10 times before I figured out what I was meant to do next. And then, yeah, the difficulty progression of the elements is just brilliant. And obviously, I haven't reached the truly, you know, the really extreme stuff like you're going to get on the epic and things. So it's, I'm so looking forward to trying those out. It's, yeah. They're not cheap puzzles, I'm happy to admit that, but if you can afford these, I'd recommend them wholeheartedly. They I've only had the one so far, and I know that the rest of the series is going to be extremely enjoyable for me, and yeah, I highly recommend them. Alright then guys, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time. Take care now.